Good morning. Welcome to the Ogama Hills Free Methodist Church. We're so glad that you are here, that we're here together as the body of Christ to worship the Lord this morning, this week of Thanksgiving. And before we open our worship with song, I want to share a little story from a devotional I had this week that I thought was kind of fun. There was once a man named Felix who was born in Cantalice, Italy. Born into a peasant family, he was a shepherd as a boy, spent a lot of times out in the fields, and cultivated his prayer life with the Lord. So by the time he was 20 years old, he entered the monastery, and he would collect food and goods for the monastery. And with every contribution that was given to him, he was known to say, "Thanks be to God." And they began to call him Brother Thanks Be to God, because he was always saying that. And one day, he came across two men who were fighting a duel. And he jumped between them, grabbed both their swords, and yelled, "Thanks be to God!" And the men were so alarmed, they yelled back, "Thanks be to God!" And he said, "The battle's over, men." And he took them aside, and they resolved their grievances, and were friends, prayed together, and were friends afterwards. So thanks be to God. And as he would walk through the streets, the children would shout out to him, "Thanks be to God." So it's a wonderful thought for us to enter this week with that in our mind and in our hearts. So I'm going to ask if you would stand with us, and we're going to sing together, "Give thanks to the Lord, our God and King. His love endures forever." Would you stand, please? From the rising to the setting sun, His love endures forever. And by the grace of God, we will carry on. His love endures forever. Sing praise. You may be seated.
Good morning, church, and welcome to Ogama Hills. We've got a few announcements for you this morning. First and foremost, we've got an update from Terry for Bible Quizzers. And she's got here, "What a rejuvenating day." Last weekend, they attended our second Bible Quiz tournament for this year at Westland Free Methodist Church. They took three amazing teams with them. Their senior team, vet team of Faith Kurtz, Corey Bertossi, and adopted quizzer Devin from Lapeer took third place, bringing home a trophy. Our young vet team of Amelia Halstead, Anastasia Kurtz, and Lily Sinkler took fifth place. And the young team rookie team of Connor Bettleton, Madison Simons, Haley Parliament took second place, bringing home a trophy. And Faith, Madison, and Amelia all quizzed out. So, yeah, awesome job. Yeah. And seven of the quizzers earned their quote ribbon this month. And Terry had to say that it was truly a day to sit back and see what God is doing in the lives of teens, and he is doing an amazing job. It was so wonderful to listen to God's word being quoted, teens laughing, having fun, and praising him. These teens are truly amazing. Thank you to all who pray for us, and we continue to have teens study in God's words. Blessings, Terry. So for those of you first-timers to Ogama Hills Free Methodist Church, or if you are a regular attender, Connect cards in the seat back in front of you. If you would fill those out just to let us know that you were here. And then on the back side, we do have prayer requests or praises. And we do have teams of volunteers praying over those throughout the rest of the week. So make sure you fill one of those out and put it in the offering basket when it comes by. And for our announcements, in your bulletin, we do have quite a few announcements this week. But this week, being Thanksgiving, we do not have Wednesday services this week. So no CLC 56 Club or youth group, as well as no adult Bible study as well. And with that being said, too, Thursday and Friday, the office will be closed. So make sure you're aware of that as well. One that's not in your bulletin that is new for us this week is the church has decided to put a float in the Christmas parade. So the week of the Christmas parade, the 7th through 12th grade youth group over at South Campus will be decorating that float instead of their normal Wednesday night routine. And then that Saturday, we're asking for their teens to volunteer to be on the float, as well as we're asking the congregation for anybody that would like to walk along the side of the float and be just a familiar face, a happy smiling face to those around us, and pass out candy. We would greatly appreciate that. If that's something you're interested in, please see me after service, and we can set that up for you. So going throughout the rest of upcoming events, bell ringers are needed for Salvation Army. There is a sign-up in the sign-up station just inside the gym there on your left. The water bottle fundraisers for Honduras, that is approaching quickly. They do need those back December 2nd, so make sure we fill those up and get those to Kay Frank. There is also, right on the welcome desk when you come in through these doors here, a sign-up for Foster Child Christmas. If you are willing and can, there are foster kids in need that we can help sponsor. Check that out. Sign up for one of those. Help those kids out, too. In the sign-up station as well, you'll find we've got the ladies' Christmas tea party coming along, too. That's coming up soon, Friday, December 7th at 6. And just a footnote in the bottom, our Love and Respect Conference coming back in February. We've got a couple months yet, but be praying for that if that's something that you want to attend to. I've attended in the past and just a great conference. So at this time, if you'll stand and join me in prayer as we head back into worship, get ready. Heavenly Father, we just come to you today to give thanks to you, Lord. You provide us with everything that we need, Lord, and we just turn to you in worship and give our hearts to you. Lord, may you be in our presence today. Lord, just touch all the people here, Lord, and just guide us along in your way. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship his holy name, sing like never before, oh my soul, I'll worship your holy name. The sun a new day dawning, it's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before, You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness, I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. Bless the my strength is failing, the end draws near, and my time has come. Still, my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Whoa. One with God, the Lord Most High. Your hidden glory in creation, now revealed in you, our Christ. What a beautiful name it is. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ, my King. What a beautiful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a beautiful name it is. The name of Jesus. You didn't want heaven without us. So Jesus, you brought heaven down. My sin was great, your love was greater. What could separate us now? What a wonderful name it is. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus Christ. What a wonderful name it is. Nothing compares to this. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a wonderful name it is. The name of Death could not hold you, the veil tore before you. You silenced the boast of sin and grave. The heavens are roaring, the praise of your glory, for you. What a powerful name it is. Nothing can stand against. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. What a powerful name it is. The name of Jesus. Be thou my vision. Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Not be all else to me save that thou art. Thou my best thought by day or by night. Waking or sleeping, thy presence, my light. Be thou my wisdom and thou my true word. I ever with thee and thou with me, Lord. Thou my
Father God, we've really just sung our prayer. We want you to be our vision. May, like the crowds that in the time of the Gospels, they came and they said we would see Jesus. Because when we see you, we see life in a whole different perspective. We see things as they really are, the good and the bad and the ugly, but with an almighty, loving Savior right there with us, helping us. Now, Father, we think of the many from our church family and, of course, our much-loved Pastor David and his family. Many are on the roads and visiting loved ones and other family members and friends. And we pray that you would be with them as people gather around their tables this Thanksgiving. I pray that there would be the recognition that the good they are experiencing is because of you. Make us like the man Carol was talking about. May the words, thanks be to God, always be upon our lips. And may we really mean it. You have been so good to us. And as you remind us in your word that every good and perfect gift comes down from the Father of heavenly lights. You are our provider. You are our protectors. We owe everything to you and we love you. And Father, we just pray now that as we give in just a moment here, that it will be that our hands reach to our pockets or purses because of what's welling up in our heart. And that is genuine gratitude and love. And so as we give, may we give not only of our material possessions, but anew this morning, may we give of ourselves back to you as you have given everything to us. In the strong name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen.